the same year in three different parts of the country, really, in the United States, and then all of a sudden come together like you guys were really meant to work together?
I mean, that's a huge part of what has kept us going along the way. It's just there have been so many things in our journey that have happened that at the time we didn't get. Several things that have happened that have been frustrating that we've looked back maybe half a year later and gone, oh my gosh, that was totally purposeful and definitely the best thing. And just so many things have happened that have just proven to us over and over that God's hand is on this and that this is, you know, and even really things as simple as just the kind of friendship that we've been able to build this around. It's just rare. It's rare even in successful acts to have the kind of relationship that the three of us have with each other.
Buddy, I gotta tell you something. I knew that faith played a role in what you did. When I saw a video on your website, you broke down in tears because you've gone through what a lot of people have gone through. You're an entrepreneur. You're not just a musician. You used every last dime to get here today.
Did you ever? It's cool. You go through so many emotions, you know, like, I mean, you just go through so much. Just when, you know, like, I don't even have a dollar. Like, I don't even have a dollar. Slowing me down. I need to run, I need to fly. It's a new beginning, man.
Being here today. Did you ever think that you'd go maybe from the backseat of a car to on stage, either opening for Taylor Swift or Tim McGraw, and go, wow, I was broke?
I know. I don't think any of us, you know, I think you have to set new goals and dream big. You have to in order to keep yourself motivated. But, you know, sitting out here on the Tim McGraw tour, I don't know if I really ever thought it was going to happen. I hoped and prayed and had faith. But until it's really happening, it's a little overwhelming just even being out here. I mean, Tim McGraw is one of our huge influences, and we're out here, you know, opening up for him. It's really a dream come true. So, yeah, it's amazing where the Lord's brought us from, really. It really is.
What would you say to this point, guys, has really been something that you'll never forget?
I mean, playing the Grand Ole Opry for the first time was one of the biggest honors, I think, any country musician or any artist could ever have. We got to play there three times last year.
What do you guys do for hobbies, man?
Well, as you can see around the corner, we carry a basketball goal with us in the trailer. It's not a particularly nice one, but fits in the trailer, and we roll it out every day, and helps us get a little sun, get a little workout in each day.
Hey, a question everybody wants to know. You go from basically, I don't want to say rags to riches, but rags to some money, okay? Have you guys ever stopped to think about, wow, I do remember when I didn't have any, so I got to be really smart going forward?
I think the biggest thing is just being able to pay your bills when they come, you know? And that alone is a driving force in wanting to be careful. And once you get like a bill that you can pay, you realize what an amazing feeling that is to just, hey, I got a phone bill and I'm not freaked out. I'm just going to pay it and move on.
I mean, we're really looking for you guys to hit it hard on stage tonight. And I'll tell you what, it's great to see three guys that can come together, because I really believe God had a plan for you guys from that first day that you came onto this earth, and it's truly showing success. And tonight, we are going to see these three guys get it on stage unlike anything you've ever seen before. We'll be right back.
a show or what?
What a show. All right, guys, if you want to hear more of Love and Theft, go to loveandtheft.com. We got everything there. And follow us on Twitter, LNG Sweets.